Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Matty Rendulic, and I welcome you to our Resonate service, a time where we can connect through music and worship, as well as meditate and take some moments away from our busy weeks to kind of reconnect with divinity externally and internally as well. Tonight, the theme of our service is simply called Breath of Life, and basically, the point of it is there's sets, because it's interesting in the Hebraic and Rabbinic Jewish tradition, life begins with breath at the crowning, and it's something that there's so much involved in breath. It's the essential mechanism of our body that keeps us alive. You can't last long if you're not breathing, although there are moments when we don't breathe, and we'll talk about those in a little bit as well. But our breaths can feel things that are full of joy, full of pain. They can feel melancholy. They can feel elation. And sometimes they can do that all concurrently. So we're going to kind of start out with understanding that breath, and certainly beginning by the breath that allows us to praise that divinity, whether it's the connected one inside of us or the divinity externally, the creative force there as well. So if you would, please stand, and it's nice to be able to sing. I believe you have bulletins in front of you, so you know, please feel free to sing as we worship God together. Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy, and nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people. Remember your children, remember your promise, O God. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough, your grace is enough for Lord of heaven and earth. Early in the morning, I will celebrate this light. And when I stumble in the darkness, I will call your name by night. God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy. The universe declares your majesty. You are holy, holy. Breath we come to is simply the breath of mercy, something that all of us recognize. We mess up nearly every day, and the biblical word that we translate from the Greek to sin is actually an archery term. It's one that simply says missing the mark. It's not so drear as the English language makes it. It's just one of those moments where you have to take a breath and a sigh and say, do you have a bleeper? I can say the swear word, but you know, say, crud, I messed up. And this breath is something that God continually breathes into us, this breath of mercy. ¶¶ watching for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home. Why should we tarry when Jesus is pleading, pleading for you and for me? Why should we linger and need not his mercies, mercies for you and for me? Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home. Time now is fleeting, the moments are passing, passing from you and from me. Shadows are gathering, deathbeds are coming, coming for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home. Oh, for the wonderful love he has promised, promised for you and for me. Pardon, pardon for you and for me. Come home, come home. You who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. I am alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. I am forgiven because you forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. I am alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. Amazing love, how can it be my King would die for me? Amazing love, I know it's true. It's my joy to honor you. we leave the breath of mercy, we come to a holy breath, a breath that recognizes this separation between us. I remember reading this anecdote, and sadly it's on social media, but I did double check to make sure it was true, where a famous anthropologist was asked, when do you think humanity became humanity? And she said, and gave the exact date and the dig and such, and basically what occurred was there was proof that among the Homo sapien population, someone suffered a broken leg, and it was healed and mended properly. And she says, you know, when people have animalistic kinds of thoughts, they don't have that kind of empathy. They don't have that kind of sympathy for healing. And that's something that is truly holy. So when we sing of the holiness of God, we sing of the lack of ego and that connecting to something greater within us, something that allows us to be separate from those kind of parts of the animal kingdom or even, sadly, the human kingdom that let people suffer. We fall down, we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. The greatness of mercy and love at the feet.
With all creation, I sing praise.
are my everything, and I will adore you. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. The next breath that we might think about together is one that is uncomfortable for so many people, but to be honest, I mean, I think about death every day a lot, and maybe I am morbid or, you know, I'm certainly psychologically ill at many times in my life, but there's something that is powerful about death. I was raised in like a schizoid religious environment where like half was Roman Catholic, and then, you know, a third was Independent Fundamentalist Baptist, and the other third was, you know, my Jewish family that we held some of the traditions with. And the odd thing about all of that was the Independent Fundamentalist Baptist had the loudest voice, and they were big into death, but it wasn't like, you know, like crying at your uncle's funeral kind of death. It was like the whole raise your hand, I'm going to glory on a train kind of death. And it was really funny. I remember this tent meeting that we had, and it makes me sound like I was born in the 50s, but I swear I was born in the 80s. Just Conneautville is kind of like the 50s and the 80s, you know, and today. But we were at this tent revival, and this loud-voiced evangelist came. He was a guest, and he was slamming on the pulpit, talking about all this sin and all this kind of stuff. And even as like an 8 or 9-year-old boy, you know, it's terrifying, you know, talking about hell and all that stuff. And he kept raising these hypothetical questions, like, if you get hit by a bus on the way out of here, you know, would you go to heaven or hell? And, you know, even at 9, I was thinking, how many buses are coming to Linesville in the middle of nowhere, you know? And but still, you know, it was just enough to, you know, persuade people into those conversion moments, whether it was manipulative or not. But I will always remember this guy who is so certain in his salvation and his final destination in his sermons, as he walked to his car in the parking lot and crossed the street, he looked both ways. And I thought that might be a tad hypocritical, right? If someone is so certain of their death and presence of that. But it just reminded me how complicated death is and how that is a part of our human experience as well, and something to be cherished, respected, and it's something that does cause those concurrent cognitive dissonant feelings of joy, you know, because many times it's the end of suffering for folk, but also deep grief. And so often we're not honest with that second part because we want to move on so quickly. So join me as we sing with the holy breath of death. Abide with me, fast falls the eventide, the darkness deepens, Lord, with me abide. When other helpers fail and comforts flee, help of the helpless, oh, abide with me. Swift to its close ebbs out life's little day. Earth joys grow dim, its glories pass away. And decay in all and round I see. O thou who changest not, abide with me. I need thy presence every passing hour. What but the grace can foil the tempter's power? Who like thyself my guide can stay can be? Through cloud and sunshine, lo, abide with me. Hold thou thy cross before thy closing eyes. Shine through the gloom and point me to the skies. As morning breaks and earth's vain shadows flee, in death, O Lord, abide with me.
Infinity in our doubt there is believing in our
move to a time in our service where we invite some much-needed silence. There is a wonderful book of poetry by Franz Wright called God's Silence. And he writes about his experience of mourning and living in emptiness. And there's something really beautiful about emptiness that we're often afraid of. You know, the Latins say, you know, something can't come out of nothing. And yet our theological background says everything came out of nothing. And perhaps to nothing it all returns, according to physics. And in these moments of emptiness, I want to remind you of those breaths that sometimes can seem lonely and full of despair. But also, there's elation in emptiness, right? Have you ever been on those roller coasters? And there's that moment that you crest the hill and you hold your breath and you don't breathe the entire time that you're down, and this whole elation just flows through your body. There's some of that in the emptiness of life, too. So we ought not get too discouraged when we think about emptiness. So take some time in silence, and I will read these poems to you as well. There is a place where even music is no longer necessary, where I am always high, where words are before somebody utters them, where leaves are before there are leaves, and where these friends who never leave me come from. No rest for the blessed, no poison, envy lushly clinging and growing around the house, twittering, darkening, everything. I will come to you, memory shining. This body is not me. Not all mankind will be cast into fire, though quite a number of them were during the decade preceding my birth, and no doubt even more will be shortly. Why? This no one knows. No one deserves this, and all deserve this, almost all. But why those particular ones, unremarkable, those before and soon? Only you know, and only you know which group, the spared or murdered, represent the doomed, and which the blessed, the ones in the fire burned clean of themselves, or those still remaining here in the shocking place that more or less randomly vanished them. In any event, blessed are the alone, for they shall be befriended, and blessed the dead, for we shall live, perhaps for the first time, still unborn in this gorgeous hell of the material. We will be inheriting soon real reality, all the peace of the universe, unending night, and the still hugely nameless majority of the stars, until the sky gives up its unendurable beauty of Bach heard by someone alone in her room dying. I wish for this sadness to leave, but it will never leave. But I am also glad. I know that at this very moment your poor head is resting on Christ's breast. I know you are comfortably seated at the Buddha's feet, listening forever to his calm voice and waiting on me still falling here toward you and following in the bodiless footsteps of God, most peripheral and unlikely of followers, keeping an eye on him from a distance and hoping to remain among the unnoticed in love. I am certain you have now contributed your creature's small light to the great peal of light, still issuing from the beginning and rapidly traveling toward us from the end. On the death of a cat. In life, death was nothing to you. I'm willing to wager my soul that it simply never occurred to your nightmareless mind while sleep was everything. See it raised to an infinite power and perfection. No death in you then, so now how even less? Dear stealth of innocence, licked polished to an evil luster, little milk fang, whiskered night friend, go. September 13th again, and the sun is shining. This leafy, largely vacant rectory is just a place for me to hang my head. It's the last day of somebody's childhood, and every day I'll try to do one thing I like in memory of being happy. If I could stop talking completely, cease talking for a year, I might begin to get well, he muttered. Off alone again, performing brain surgery on himself in a small, badly lit room with no mirror. A room whose floor, ceiling, and walls are all mirrors. What a mess, oh my God. And still it stands. The question, not how to begin again, but rather, why? So we sit there together, the mountain and me, Li Po said, until only the mountain remains. Not to dwell too long in emptiness, there is certainly a breath of hope as well that we live into our lives. And to give the Independent Fundamentalist Baptists a little bit of equal time, they are really good at living in hope as well. So I hope that you will join me in singing these songs of hope. Please stand as we sing. We will dance together. A song of celebration, lift up a shout of praise, for the bridegroom has come, the glorious one, and oh, we will look on his face, we'll go to a much better up your hands and clap for joy. The time's drawing near when he will appear. And oh, we will stand by his side, a strong and pure spotless bride. Oh, we will dance on the streets that are golden, the glorious bride and the great Son of Man. From every tongue and tribe and nation will join in the song of the Lamb. Sing a song of celebration, lift up a shout of praise, for the bridegroom is come, the glorious one, and oh, we'll look on his face, we'll go to a much better place, and dance with all your might. For joy, the time's coming near.
over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious song from the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more, not a sigh for the blessing of rest. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. To our bountiful Father above, we will offer the tribute of praise for the glorious gift of his love and the blessing that hallow our days. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
You have blessed me. So as we depart from this evening's worship service, I bless you with all of the holy breath that God gives you of life. Live into all of it. The joy, the sadness, the elation, the pain. Live, because God is the God of life and he is a living God. Be blessed by God, our Creator, Jesus Christ, our Liberator, and Holy Spirit, our constant guide and friend. Amen. Thank you.